Hi, everyone. Meet May. May is a forensic psychologist. A forensic psychologist is a person who studies criminals and their crimes. Then, the information they find is used to understand characteristics of criminal behavior. Forensic psychologists do other things, too. Many work with lawyers to help pick people to sit on juries. They do this to make sure that the lawyer has the best jury possible to help his or her client. Today, May is recording a podcast about jury bias. A bias is a strong belief in support of or against something. For example, a person may not like a certain grocery store chain because of a bad experience. He or she may show bias by refusing to shop at any store that is part of that grocery chain. In her podcast, May hopes to show how jury bias can hurt or help a person accused of a crime. She will begin by discussing the Sixth Amendment to the Constitution of the United States. The Sixth Amendment outlines the rights of an accused person when they go to trial. This includes the right to a trial by an unbiased jury. A jury is a group of average people who have been chosen to decide if a person is guilty or innocent. After the age of 18, every American can be chosen to serve on a jury. You might have to serve on one when you get older. To be chosen to serve on a jury, a person must first be selected to a jury pool. Computers randomly select a group of people to come to the courthouse. The people that are selected get a special letter called a summons in the mail. Then they are asked questions in order to judge their biases. May wants to emphasize the idea that an accused person has the right to a jury that is unbiased. This is very important if the accused person is to receive a fair trial. This means that the people picked for the jury must not have an opinion on whether the accused person is innocent or guilty before they hear all of the evidence of a case. Every American has the right to a fair trial, which means an unbiased jury is very important. If a jury is too biased, then an innocent person could go to jail and a guilty person could be set free. Before a court case is heard in a jury trial, lawyers interview jurors to try to discover any biases that could affect their ability to be fair. The lawyers will ask questions to get a sense of how a juror thinks or feels about certain topics. The lawyers have the option to dismiss a small number of jurors. This is done so a jury can judge a case as fairly as possible. As lawyers ask questions, the forensic psychologist will watch each person. He or she will make notes about the person's answers, his or her facial expressions, and even how they behave as the lawyer is talking to other people. Based on the answers given to the persons in the jury pool, the forensic psychologist and the lawyers will make decisions about who they think will be the best jurors in their case. May is also going to talk about how social media makes it hard for a forensic psychologist to determine jury bias. In many criminal trials, people may have already formed an opinion about a crime or the accused because of things that they have seen posted on social media. These are just some of the ways that a forensic psychologist works with lawyers and the criminal justice system to make sure that people on trial are treated fairly. May hopes that her podcast will get people to think about how important it is for trials to be fair and how bias can affect the outcome of a court case. Now it's your turn to go on an adventure and be a forensic psychologist.